الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. In continuation of our revision class, as we promised ourselves earlier time that next class will be on algebraic fraction. When we are treating algebraic fraction last time, we discussed about algebraic fraction without brackets and fraction with brackets. Now, we want to start with algebraic fraction without brackets. Look at the board. We have number 1 to be 5, all over 2d plus 7 over 2d. The second one says 5 over 4a minus 2 over 3a. Look at the two questions. You see there's difference between the two. The first question has the same denominator, while the second question has different denominator. Fraction without bracket, as I said, it can be of the same denominator, it can be of different denominator. Those are the two samples of it. Let's now look at how to solve that one. Whether it's the same denominator or different denominator, the first step is to know the LCM of the denominator. For instance, 5 over 2d plus 7 over 2d. Our LCM will be 2d because the denominators are the same. Then we make our LCM to be the general denominator. From here, we now look at the number of first term. How many times can 2d go in 2d? Only one time. Multiply by what is in top before, 5. How must 2d goes in 2d 1 multiply by the numerator, which is 7. Then we operate. 5 times 1 give us 5 plus 1 times 7 give us 7. Everything over 2d. Let's add the numerator together. 5 plus 7 will give us 11. Everything over 2d. Give us 12, sorry. That 12 over 2d. If you look at 12 and 2d, there's something in common. 12 can be written as 2 and 6. Why 2d can be 2 into bracket d? Because 2 is common to 12, that is also common to 2d. In that case, 2 can take care of the 2. We are left with what? 6 over 2d. That's our final answer. If you look at this step, I make sure 2 can go in the 2 before I divide. If 2 cannot go in the 2, I don't need to divide. Then I will leave my answer like that. Before you can divide, make sure that thing you want to use to divide is a common factor to both numerator and denominator. Look at second one. We have to have 5 over 4a minus 2 all over 3a. In this case, our denominator is different. It's not the same. We have to look for the LCM of 4a and 3a. What will be the LCM? The LCM will be 12a. 12a. Make the LCM the general denominator. We now have 12a at the bottom. How many times can 4a go in 12a? A will take care of a. 4 in 12, we have 3. Everything multiplied by 5, that is numerator, minus. How many times can 3 go in 12a? A will take care of a. 3 in 12, we have 4. Everything multiplied by 2. From there, we have 15 minus 8, everything over 12a. Look at that very well. Can we subtract that one? 15 minus 8, all over 12a will give us what? It will give us 7 all over 12a. That will be our final answer. That's the first aspect of the algebraic fraction. When we are solving this, who did not introduce brackets. Here, when we introduce brackets, it's because we want to factorize 12. That bracket is not part of our solution. We can use multiplication here instead of brackets as issue. We can use times here instead of brackets. Doesn't mean anything. But the one with bracket, if you don't use bracket, you miss it. Let's use sample of that. Fraction with bracket. Fraction with bracket. For example, let's assume we have this as an example. X plus 3, everything over 5 plus 4x minus 2, everything over 5. Take for example this as well. 7a minus 3, everything over 6 minus 3a plus 5, everything over 4. Let's put that. Looking at it as well, you can see the one with the same denominator, other one with different denominator. Look at the two aspects of it too. It will be the same denominator, it will be different denominator. Start from the first one. Here we have x plus 3 all over 5 plus 4x minus 2, everything over 5. The numerators are the same. Our LCM will be 5. Then we make the LCM general denominator. In that case, 5 goes in 5, 1. Here, we cannot use 1 times x plus 3. We miss it. In that case, we introduce brackets. That is why it is classified as fraction with brackets. Am I talking? Plus 5 plus 5, 1, into bracket 4s minus 2. Why bracket? What's the function of bracket there? It means this one outside belongs to x and 3. But if you say 1 multiplied by x plus 3, it means this one have x, but 3 does not have 1. That is the meaning. But here with bracket, it means both x and 3, they both are 1 outside the brackets. Let's continue. From there we have to remove the brackets. How will we remove the brackets? We remove the other way, say 1 times x, 1 times 3, 3, plus 1 times 4x, 4x, plus 1 times minus 2, minus 2, everything all over 5. From here, you can see some terms are the same, some terms are alike. Then we have to collect like term. We have to collect like term, x here, 4x here. Plus 3 here, minus 2, everything all over 5. You can see x and 4x will give us what? 5x. 3 and minus 2 give us what? Plus 1. Simply because 3 are plus and is the highest. Your value will be in plus. Everything all over 5. Okay, they say 3 naira. We have this as final answer. Why is it final answer? Although 5 can go in 5, 5 can go in 5, but 5 cannot go in 1. So we leave it like that. Assuming we have something of this nature, 5x plus 5 up over 5. In that manner, we have 5 here, 5 here. We take it out. X plus 1, all over 5. So 5 can now be 5, 5, because 5 has now common to them. 5 months cannot cancel 5 because 5 is now common to them. But here, 5 is not common. Then we leave it like that as our final answer. I believe it's clear. That is that about fraction. That's that about fraction. Let's do one or two classwork. So if you do that, send it to me. I will have to mark it and give you the feedback. The first one you are given, none of you submit. I don't know the reason why. But later, I will find out the reason why you did not submit your given exercise. This will be exercise two. This will be exercise two. That for the exercise, solve it and send it to the page. We have the solution this night. So, we're not going to be there.